This here is 2021. Done. But with that said, right, there have been some really great things that have came out for streamers and content creators this year, like Streamlabs Desktop. No, but seriously, there have been some really incredible resources that have came out for streamers and content creators, not just on Twitch, but on YouTube and on mobile platforms as well. This video, I'm going to go through some of them, tell you what they're about and why I think they're good. That's it. That's the intro. Let's start. Actually, I do need this. This is a journal. So it was a metaphor. So just before we begin, any plugin, tool, whatever that I mentioned today, I'm going to leave a link to go and grab it in the description, and it will be in the order that I mention it, as well as any useful videos that I might recommend, because there are a couple of good ones in here as well. All right, number one is Exeldro's Move Transition. Now, it got released in 2020, pretty early in 2020 actually, but since then he has updated it so much, and throughout this year as well, it is not the same plugin that it was once back then, okay? It is so much better. It has so much more in it than just simply moving something on your screen around. But I didn't realize the power of the plugin whenever you use it to move values of filters. So say you put it on to something that was on your stream that had a color, and you could teach it to basically move from one color to another. You could use it to gradually blur your screen. You could use it to continually loop something. So if you wanted to have your webcam moving just a little bit constantly, as if it was like a kind of handheld situation, or you wanted to use the DVD screensaver effect where you bounce your webcam or something, you could do that with the Move plugin. It's really incredible. I do recommend getting it. And of course, it's free. So yeah, get stuck in. So the next plugin I'm going to recommend came out in 2017. We're not doing 2021. Updates? There's been updates. That's why we're recommending this one. We being me, there's nobody over there. That was just a bit. It didn't work. Moving on! This plugin is called StreamFX, and it's by Zaymar, and you probably already have it. There have been a serious amount of updates to it. In this last year alone, 3D Transform has seen an upgrade where you can use corner pins to designate the exact location of every corner of a source. He's updated things like the source mirror, which, you know, if you don't use it already, you should, because it's incredible. It lets you double sources, and you can apply effects to the mirror that you've just made that won't affect the original source. Kind of like scene nesting, but just way quicker. He added a auto framing filter, which was kind of like the old face tracking filter that Nvidia used. There's a video super resolution filter, which is really good for upscaling things like low resolution capture cards or low resolution web cameras, even old stream recordings. So if you want to add a bit of definition into those things, you can do this with this filter. There's so much stuff, just go check it out. By the time you're done looking at the patch notes, it's going to be New Year's Day, so I would start now. So number three is Source Record by Exeldro, and that did come out this year, so we're kind of on the theme of 2021 again. It's incredible. It lets you record sources separately. So let me give you an example. Say I'm doing a tutorial and I'm capturing my desktop, but I'm also capturing my webcam. I could run two different versions of OBS, one capturing my webcam, one capturing my desktop, or I could just put the source record filter on my desktop and my webcam and have it set up so that it records both as separate videos. Okay, so hear me out. This is a great example of why you would want this as a live streamer. Say you use the replay buffer, or you record your entire stream while you're streaming, and there's a great moment, you marker it, and then you go later to check it out, but someone has donated bits and it's maybe showing the alert over a great part of the clip that you were going to use. And it kind of makes it a bit wasted, because you want to put it up on TikTok or YouTube Shorts, and you can't really have the original source because there's a big alert in front of it. You can put a source record on your webcam and on your gameplay, so whenever you go to edit this, you don't have to worry about the alerts popping up and ruining a great moment of your gameplay that you wanted to clearly show. Good plugin. Get it. This next tool is Clippy. I've actually done a video on this already. Essentially, what Clippy does is it is a shout out tool that interacts with the people you want to shout out. It's not only that though, you can use it to interact with your chat. If they bring a clip into chat that you want to watch on stream with them. You can do that by letting them post in the URL, and then you can use the command !watch, and it will watch that clip on your stream. It's a pretty cool tool. You can use it with your mods as well, so they can vet things. And it's just a nice thing to do for people who host a Raji at the very least. It acts as a browser source in OBS, so you pretty much just connect it with your Twitch, take the URL, and you put that into OBS. It's really straightforward, really good tool. I highly recommend it. The next plugin I'm going to recommend is Featured Chat, and I'm not going to go into too much detail on this because there is a fantastic video made by Pete Wilkins, Gaming Careers. If you haven't heard of Pete, where have you been? He has done a great video on Featured Chat, and it basically lets you bring in messages from chat and feature them on your stream. The clue's in the name. It's a good plugin. It's got a lot of great features. Again, just go check out the video. I have the link in the description. And if you're not a Twitch streamer, unfortunately, Featured Chat is Twitch only right now. But in the meantime, I'm aware there is a plugin called Twidget. I haven't looked into it that much, but it covers some of the features of Featured Chat. I'm personally a bigger fan of the intuitive design from Featured Chat's perspective over Twidget, but if you've got literally nothing else to try, I would recommend giving that a go and seeing what you think. I'm actually going to send you to another video by Pete, aka Gaming Careers. We did a video on this a while ago. It is an incredible plugin. If you don't have a Go XLR or Voice Meter or the Wavelink software, and you're looking for a free solution for that within OBS, the Win Audio Capture plugin is the way to go. It gives you control over every bit of audio you could possibly want to have control over. Your game audio, your microphone, your Discord, and your alerts, your music, you name it. It's extremely easy to set up and it's really powerful. I'm going to say no more on it because I think you should go and check out the video by Pete on this and just give it a go. It's an incredible plugin and they're actively updating it all the time, so I'm expecting even better things from it in 2022. I got water on my glasses. Just give me a second. Is this how people are supposed to look when they take their glasses off? Can't see a thing. And then? Oh yeah, that's better. Yeah, let's continue. For the longest time, I've used a plugin called Transition Matrix to transition between scenes in different ways. So say you wanted to fade into one scene, but coming back from that scene, you wanted to use a different transition altogether. That is the most basic way I can explain it. But as of late, I find myself using a plugin by Exeldro, surprise, surprise, and it's called Transition Table. It came out in January 2021, and it does the same thing where it allows you to set a transition from point and a transition to point. Explain what the transition should be, how long the duration should be, and set up any amount of configurations that you want. Now, some people may still prefer to use Transition Matrix. I do still love the layout of Transition Matrix, weirdly enough, but I am a fan of Transition Table. Exeldro does great stuff, and this is another great plugin. There's so many little things you could do with this, so I definitely recommend checking this one out. The next one is Media Looper by Nerd or Die, and it's a banger, and it's also absolutely free. You're welcome. The clue for what Media Looper is in the name. It loops media on your stream. So say you have a handful of socials that you want to show on stream, you can do that with Media Looper. If you don't have any whatsoever, the Media Looper pack actually comes with some pre-made ones. We did a pretty good tutorial on it explaining how to set it up for yourself and use it with the content that is available on Nerd or Die's website, as well as just your own content in general. Did I mention it's free? All of this stuff is free. You guys have got it good. I mean, I've got it good as well, so it's fine. It's okay. So yeah, Media Looper, good stuff. So you're streaming on Twitch and you just got an absolute banger of a clip. Clip it. And you want to take that clip, you want to convert it, put it on your TikTok, on your YouTube, Instagram, and just get it out there without fuss. But you want it to look good, right? Obviously. Combo is a website that lets you sign in with your Twitch account and pull in your clips that then you can edit within their software on their website. You can also upload those clips if you don't want to import them from your channel, and you can edit them right there and then, trimming it to the perfect point, combining different layers, texts, overlays, and so much more to make that clip just that little bit better. You know, even though it's an absolute banger, you just want to make it a little bit better, a little bit better,
a little bit better.
That's going to be, I'm going to hear that in my head quite a lot. And once you're done editing that clip, you can download it and upload it to all your social media platforms or just publish right from Combo. I love these stats they have. 5 clicks on average to edit a video. over 10 million views of combo creator videos, and the average time to edit a video is 3 minutes. I don't know about 5 clicks and 3 minutes. If it took me 3 minutes to do 5 clicks, I may need to go and lie down. But having used the software, I can definitely attest to the 3 minutes average, because it takes no time to get your stuff sorted. Do give it a go, and if you like it, tell other people that combo exists. Sharing is actually caring, so yeah. Spread the word. 6 hour timer and my book is gone. Gotta get up and switch it back on. It's good. We're good to go. We keep going. This plugin is by the incredible MrBoost. He makes all kinds of amazing stuff. I could just do a video on MrBoost, honestly. This is yet another amazing thing that he's put together. It's a Spotify widget, and I know there's a lot out there, but trust me, this is the best looking one I've seen so far. I really love this. It pulls the colors of the actual album artwork in to use for the font, and it just looks really great. It looks really simple to set up. He's put out a nice guide for it if you're looking for a nice looking simplified Spotify player for your streams. This is the go-to. I give it 5 defrags. I don't know, do we have a rating system? If it was, it would be 5 out of 5 defrags. Okay, so 5 out of 5 defrags. Can we put that on screen somewhere? Me, I edit my own videos, I don't have an editor. Get the widget, the final tool, which I think, given the past 2 years, this is something that is overlooked a lot, and I really think everyone should be considering a bit of mental wellness whenever they can take it. It is a grueling experience to be a content creator, to be self-employed, to judge yourself on a daily basis so harshly against the creations of others, and this tool lets you step back from it a bit. It's called Goodbye Metrics. It's a Chrome extension, but I believe you could use it for the likes of Brave Browser as well if you use that. It hides key metrics on YouTube, so things like comments, you can remove all comments from YouTube's, not just your own channel, but just in general. You can remove the like and dislike features. You can remove subscriber numbers that you see on different channels. You can hide your creator stats, like your channel analytics, latest comments, latest video performance, your published videos. It also can remove everybody else's video stats, so you don't feel like you're comparing yourself constantly to others. And you can just enjoy the content that you're creating and others are creating, and just try and forget for a while about the numbers.